Good morning, students. Myself Nitesh Pandey, working as an assistant professor in Mechanical Engineering Department of Sri Ram Swarup Memorial University. In the last class, we have discussed about the purpose of gating system. So, in today's class, what we will discuss that what are the various elements which are required to pour the molten material from ladle up to the mold cavity. So, what are the various elements which are required? Are the first one is your pouring basin. What pouring basin is? Pouring basin basically act as a reservoir in which molten material is collected, and the molten material when got collected here, it will reach up to the mold cavity in minimum possible time by being filtered from a strainer or a skim core which is attached here. So pouring basin basically act as a reservoir where molten material can be stored, and from there it could reach to the mold cavity through a sprue base well and runner. Second one is your sprue. What is the purpose of sprue? Basically, sprue is a tapered passage. It is basically a tapered passage through which molten material will enter from pouring basin up to the sprue base well. Why it is kept as tapered? It is kept as tapered because since molten material is coming down from pouring basin up to the sprue base well, since it is coming down, it has some velocity, and because of that velocity, we have to maintain the velocity, so the cross sectional area at the bottom should be less so that the velocity could be maintained. That's why this is placed in the tapered position. If it is not being made in the tapered position, it may lead to the air aspiration. What is air aspiration? Air aspiration is an effect which may lead to the trapping up of atmospheric air into the sprue. So, sprue is designed in such a way that it should avoid the air aspiration effect. Third one is your sprue base well. What is the purpose of sprue base well? The purpose of sprue base well is when the molten material having some velocity and high temperature, when it will directly enter into the mold cavity, it may lead to the mold erosion. That's why sprue base well is placed here. If the sprue base well is placed here, then the molten material will came and get collected here, so that the mold erosion means it will leads to the mold erosion. Means mold erosion will not take place if the sprue base well is there, so that it can act as a reservoir which provide a pathway for the molten material to enter into the runner. So basically, sprue base well is also a reservoir which is placed at the end of sprue in order to avoid the mold erosion effect. The next term is your runner. Runner is basically placed in the horizontal plane. Why it is placed in horizontal plane? It is placed in horizontal plane so that the molten material could enter into the mold cavity from various gates. The purpose of runner is, the shape of runner is basically in the trapezoidal shape. So this is the purpose of your runner. Means it will lead a passage so that molten material will enter into the mold cavity from in gate. Next one is your runner extension. Runner extension is placed at the end of your given gating system so that the impurities, because it has some velocity, so impurities will get, if the impurities came up to this point, it may be collected at the end of your runner extension. So this is the purpose of your runner extension. Next one is your ingate. What is the purpose of ingate? Ingate is the last entry point from where molten material will enter into the mold cavity from runner extension. So ingate is the last entry point from where molten material will enter into the mold cavity. Last one is riser. Riser basically it is of various type, and it is generally used for preventing, or it is used for providing the directional solidification of casting. So this is the last element of your gating system, that is riser, which is used for providing the directional solidification. So all these are the various elements which are provided in gating system in order so that the molten material will enter from pouring basin up to the mold cavity. Thank you, students.